Hello everybody, my name is Akili Brenda Nancy. I work for THRIVEGulu Senior Empowerment Manager. Today I am happy to talk about our gender-based violence program at THRIVEGulu. So gender-based violence is an act that is perpetrated against the person's will and is based on gender norms and an equal power relation. And gender-based violence can be in form of physical, emotional or psychological, economical or sexual. And some of the effects of gender-based violence, physically, a person can be injured, can cause disability or chronic health problems. A psychological, gender-based violence can cause anxiety, fear, inability to concentrate, and even post-traumatic stress. Economically, gender-based violence can cause reduced ability to participate in economic activities. Sexually, gender-based violence can increase teenage pregnancies in communities, forced marriages, and many more. Gender-based violence affects both women, men, girls, and boys, but mostly in communities, women and girls are most affected. So this is the reason why we need to educate community to be aware of prevention and response strategies. They should be aware to report whenever they see cases of gender-based violence happening in their community, as well as strengthen community structures to support community to respond and also prevent gender-based violence. We've done a number of things. We've supported prevention and response of gender-based violence in communities of Gulu and Moro district in northern Uganda. So what we have done, provided community education and sensitization to the community and response strategies. We have encouraged community to report and to act within their means, because the community themselves have a part to play in preventing and responding to gender-based violence. We've conducted community dialogue to understand community's efforts, ability to respond, and also to prevent gender-based violence. We've conducted radio talk shows to speak about how community can help to reduce and also prevent gender-based violence in their community. We've produced messages that are played as spot messages on radio to pass messages. And we've identified and strengthened community-based structures so that they are able to respond to cases of gender-based violence in the community. We've identified and linked survivors to different service points based on needs a particular survivor could be having. We've also identified and trained gender-based violence monitors within the communities, and their roles are one, to report cases of gender-based violence to different service points within the community, refer gender-based violence survivors and their caregivers to different service points, and also educate survivors and their families on the different service points that exist within their community. They support, monitor condition of survivors, and whenever they identify other more needs of the survivor, then they are able to refer or to report to different service points. Our gender-based violence monitors also provide basic counseling to the survivors whenever there is need. And we facilitate and supervise and also strengthen the gender-based violence monitors so that they do their roles within their community. We provide professional counseling services through our THRIVEGulu professional counselors, so that they support the survivor and their families to be able to overcome their trauma. In the end, the survivors thrive. So as we move towards a celebration of World Mental Health Day, we should know that gender-based violence is real and that it is one of the great causes of mental health problems in the communities. So I thank you very much for your support. I thank you for every little support that you give is helping a survivor thrive in the community. Thank you very much.